Yeah, it was even shorter for myself from Nations. So yeah. I literally had, I think, 7 days after I got home from France. I was straight out here right into testing. I mean, we got a lot of new stuff on the bike this year, so it was kind of important to get on it kind of right away.
Did you do anything fun in those 7 days?
The fun part was France. Dude, okay. That trip to France with my family was unreal. I mean, yeah, the racing, we kind of got smoked, but the off the bike stuff, being in Paris, the fan base, like, man, it was cool. And then when we got back, hit a country concert with Jason Aldean, just a couple of things with my wife here and there, but like I said, we're right back into it.
Plessinger said the driving for Nations was like terrifying. It was like mopeds going around you like 100 miles an hour,
dude. And then also I got two tickets and there dude, there was flashes. All right, so leaving France, the Nations, we drove back to Paris. There's no one on the road, and like, so I'm cruising. I don't know the speed limit because I'm doing like 160 kilometers or whatever that is. So I have no idea how fast I'm actually going. And like, I see flashes in the trees. I'm like, someone taking a picture, like whatever. Dude, sure enough, 2 weeks later, and get an email, like $150, whatever. But it's all in French, so I don't even know how to read it. I'm probably have a warrant out in France, but I'm, yeah, no way.
Be honest, did you pay? No?
No, that's what I'm saying. I don't know how. It's not in English. I can't even translate it.
Dude, all right. Well, aside from the tickets, that experience looked unbelievable, dude. I know Redbud out here is obviously a really, really cool designations location, but that venue looked like just ridiculous. I heard there were cars on fire and whatnot. Just
Man,
talk about it a little bit.
It was like, you can't put it into words really how to describe it. I was sitting on the gate, behind the gate for Saturday. Like, it wasn't even Sunday yet. It was Saturday, our qualifying race. And there was like a clap going on, like in the fans. And there were so many people and it was so like loud in a valley and where we were on the start. Like, you could literally feel like the ground like pulsing with the claps. Like, man, it was insane. And like, our US fans are awesome. Those European fans were next level. Like, you can't put it into words how awesome and cool that whole experience was. Like I said, I felt like I rode pretty well, but we did get smoked. But other than getting smoked, it was the best trip that I've been on.
I heard there are a lot of like guys in dresses running around. So.
Yeah, there was some kind of crazy stuff. But if you want a party, if I was not racing, dude, I would probably still be stuck in France.
All right, aside from those Nations, dude, you had honestly quite the year. Sure, some heartbreak, but you really had some flashes of brilliance and just showed you got it. Are you happy with it all?
Yeah, man. Like, it took me so long just to even get a Supercross win and the podiums and stuff like that. They did not come easy for years and years, and then last year they finally felt like, okay, like you belong here, and you were knocking them off, and man, it was a huge step in my career, and now I'm at that next step now where it's okay, it's time to put it all together. A lot of people behind the scenes, a lot of people in my group, I'm getting old, so the chances of me winning a title are getting slimmer and slimmer, like my time frame to do it. So I feel like I got to get it done this year. Like, these guys believe in me. I believe in myself. I don't even really feel the pressure, though. That's the thing where it's like, okay, I'm 27. I feel young. Like, mentally, I still feel really young because I keep learning. I keep getting better and better each year. It's time to put it together. And I feel like, you know, this year, 24, it's going to be the year for the 24.
Great. It seems like you guys made, like, huge strides with the machine last year. Is it just long days at the practice tracks? Did you guys find stuff? Like, what do you address that to?
It's hard to say. Like, it's hard to pinpoint one thing. Like, there's so many things going on, and you know, we were asking for so much whenever we first got the new bike, and we honestly went the wrong way in a lot of, you know, areas, where now it was like, okay, we learned the bike and we learned the frame and everything about it. Now we can go in the right direction and get more options and more kind of things we can mess around with to find some more comfort here and there. You see my bike, there's quite a bit different than even just last year. Like I definitely think that the jump that we took from 22 to 23, we're gonna take from 23 to 24. I'm really happy with my bike already. And I'm just excited. Like, it feels like, honestly, I haven't even stopped racing. But just to have a fresh start again, everybody's at zero going into a round. Like I said, having an awesome team behind me ready to go win.
Hey, we've had kind of like an exodus at the Baker's Factory this offseason, and I feel like that leaves you as kind of the veteran guy there.
Yeah.
Especially with these new kids on the team, do you feel any more responsibilities and kind of showing everyone around?
I do feel like I'm almost like the dad there. Like, even with Malk and Christian, like, I'm able to kind of control kind of the mood quite a bit on what's going on and the vibes around the place. And honestly, we've had one day where it was getting a little bit off the path of where we should have been. And that was the first time I was like, okay, like, you know, I kind of got to bring it back here. And we ended up doing that within, you know, 20, 30 minutes. So just kind of seeing like how much that impacts the day and how you're able to carry yourself throughout, you know, your training and everything else. Like, it plays a big factor on, you know, everybody there. We have an awesome group there. You know, everybody wants to be better. Everybody pushes each other to be better, which is cool. It's cool to have, and it's fun to be a part of it. I mean, this is year four. Yeah, I believe it's year four there at Alden's. Still enjoy it. Man, I love the suffer. Love showing up to work every day still.
Talk about the young blood on the team a little bit. Ferris just seems like a kid that's like really chasing a dream still. And Casey, obviously, he's been an aspiring amateur rider. So is it just cool having him around?
Man, I honestly, me and Ferris, like, me and, I call him Gilly. Like, I was so mad at him at Hangtown. I didn't even know him. I just heard he's a good kid, whatever, came over. Hangtown, me and him beefed it out last year. Like, dude, I was like, I'm going to kill the kid. Like, we got into it a couple of times. And then he had a first turn crash at Thunder Valley, and I was in it. He breaks his arm, whatever. That's it. Then full circle, comes around. He's my teammate now. And now I learn a lot more kind of backstory on him and, you know, his family and stuff. And, man, I got a lot of respect for the kid. Like, I don't think anyone really knows his true story or, you know, what all is going on. And for a kid to, I think he's 20 now, be on his own, new country, you know, no family, and full steam ahead. Like, he doesn't complain. He wants to be better. Supercross is hard, dude. I don't care what anybody says. It's gnarly. And for someone to come in and have no experience on it, and he can learn off of us now, but you also, you know, he doesn't have someone to, you know, be there at home or whatever that kind of knows what's all going on. I want the kid to do good. I think he will. Like, it's gonna be a probably pretty tough year, but just learn everything you know you can. It's really all he can really hope for is this year is just to learn. Everybody likes him around the team. You know, he's awesome to have around. Same with Casey. I mean, I've known Casey for a while now, and I think he'll be, you know, really successful. Just learn as much as what he can this year.
Hey, I think you guys got the opportunity to do your own goggle deals this year.
Yeah. True? Yep. Yep. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. For a lot of people, don't understand like some of the stuff that goes on with a 2BD team and not being able to do all your own personal sponsors. So that's had to be pretty cool.
Yeah, man. It was awesome. It was kind of last minute, which was a bummer. But I went to the best company there is and the best goggle there is. First call was to Paggio at Oakley, and he was my guy, an amateur. Haven't been able to run him since I've turned pro, and said, hey, look, man, I know it's late. All the deals are probably done already, but I want to be with you guys. I want to run Oakley. Sure enough, yeah, we got the deal done. So stoked to be back with Oakley and get to be in, you know, I'd say the best thing goggle there is right now.
All right, lastly, I assume we can expect you to see you at A1 on the West Coast?
Yep, yeah, no, I'm full blown. I'll be at A1, spending the month out here in California. Man, ready to knock a win off here early.